है गाइस, वेलकम टू मैक मिश्रा। हियर आई एम टुडे अवेलेबल विद यू ऑन द न्यू टॉपिक, दैट्स अ कोरोजन मैकेनिज्म, इट्स अ क्लोराइड स्ट्रेस कोरोजन क्रैकिंग। सो स्टे विद मी टिल द एंड ऑफ द सेशन। यू विल बेसिकली नो ऑल द बेसिक थिंग्स एंड एट द एंड ऑल द डीप थिंग्स अबाउट द क्लोराइड स्ट्रेस कोरोजन क्रैकिंग, विच इज़ ए वेरी कॉमन डैमेज मैकेनिज्म एंड विच इंजीनियर हैज़ टू डील इन डे टू डे लाइफ। सो इट्स अ वेरी ट्रिकी वन एंड वेरी क्रिटिकल वन, डिपेंड्स ऑन द वेरियस ऑल द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ पैरामीटर। सो यू नीड टू स्टे विथ मी एट द एंड टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस मैकेनिज्म एंड देन यू विल बी एबल टू अप्लाई दिस इन योर डे टू डे प्रैक्टिसेस। ओके, सो स्टार्ट द ट्रेनिंग सेशन। सो फर्स्ट बेसिकली व्हाट इज क्लोराइड स्ट्रेस कोरोजन क्रैकिंग? इट्स अ कंबाइंड इफेक्ट ऑफ थ्री थिंग्स। फर्स्ट इज द इन्वायरमेंट, सो देयर शुड बी अ ससेप्टेबल इन्वायरमेंट टू काज स्ट्रेस कोरोजन क्रैकिंग। सो बेसिकली इट्स अ क्रैकिंग फिनोमिना इज अकॉम्पनाइड बाई द स्ट्रेस। देन देयर शुड बी ए ससेप्टेबल मेटलर्जी, मीन्स मेटेरियल शुड बी आर सच टाइप विच कैन कॉज द स्ट्रेस कोरोजन क्रैकिंग। देन फाइनली द स्ट्रेसेज इन द मटेरियल विच मे बी रेसिडुअल और अप्लाइड। सो बेसिकली थ्री फैक्टर्स आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द स्ट्रेस कोरोजन क्रैकिंग। सो मटेरियल इन पैसिव स्टेट ससेप्टेबल टू अटैक। There should be an aggressive environment, like here in chloride stress corrosion cracking, chloride environment is an aggressive environment. Then the stresses. So stresses may be due to the fabrication and may be due to its position. So basically stresses, all the stresses, tensile stresses. So this may be residual, means that present in the welding, that will be always present in our plant. Then applied, that is bends, means this is applied applied stress. So basically how CLSCC looks like, it's a branch cracking, it may be intergranular or transgranular. Here you can see this cracking mechanism, so we'll learn in detail. So first basic definition, what's a chloride stress corrosion cracking? These are the surface initiated cracking of 300 stainless steel. So basically this much more prone to 300 or strength stainless steel, okay, and some nickel based alloys under combined action of tensile stress, but we discussed is a temperature effect and aqueous chloride environment. Okay, so it's also referred as chloride cracking. So now what are the affected materials for this CLSCC to cause? So all this 300 grade austenitic stainless steel are highly susceptible for this. Now coming to duplex are more resistant but still susceptible, and nickel based alloys are highly resistant but they are also not immune. So if you want to upgrade, so we can go from 300 to duplex. Still if our conditions are not means we are operating at high temperature, high chloride, we need to proceed for this. Okay, so what are the critical factors for chloride CC to occur? So first is the chloride content. If there is a high chloride, there will be very high probability of the CLSCC. But even small amount of chloride, even 1 ppm is also capable to cause stress corrosion cracking at higher temperatures. Okay, and basically the chloride which is free in form is responsible for the CLSCC, that are the inorganic chloride, because these are the reactive chlorides which are available in Cl minus form. What about organic chlorides? Organic chlorides are not causing immediate CLSCC, but they are sometimes responsible to cause CLSCC. So first critical factor is chloride environment. Second is temperature. So basically, temperature is also a critical factor. When temperature increases, the probability of CLCC also increase. So if it's a more prominent, CLCC chances are more if temperature is 60 degree and above. But at lower temperature also, there is a probability of this CLCC to occur depending on other factors. Then the pH is also a critical factor. Basically, acidic pH are more prone to CLCC. Now coming to the tensile stresses are also important factor. So basically, this may be residual or applied. We discuss residual present in the welding, rolling, or during the fabrication process, and applied is the which is applied. So basically, tensile stresses are responsible for this CLCC, but compressive stresses can resist. Means if there is stresses as compressive stresses, there will be less chances of CLCC to occur. Then presence of oxygen is also a critical factor. If oxygen is more in our system, the chances of CLCC will be much higher, because the more oxygen, it will change the electrode potential. You know, corrosion to occur, there is a huge effect on of electrode potential on corrosion to occur. So presence of oxygen changes the electrode potential in CSCC susceptible zone. And last one is alloy composition. So we have told all the 300 stainless steel, means SS304, 316L, are much more prone for the CLCC. So how cracks look like? Its cracks are branched in nature. It may be intergranular or transgranular. Now we will understand the mechanism for the chloride stress corrosion cracking. So first how this CLCC starts, although there is not the research is still going on, and there is not specific foolproof mechanism of CLCC to occur is defined, but there are certain different types of theories are there which basically explains how CLCC occurs. So first, CLCC starts with the pitting. It may be due to the damaging of this protective film. Then from the pitting, crack starts from a pit, that is we are calling initiation site. Then crack propagates through the metal in a transgranular or intergranular mode, and then failure occurs. So see here, it's like a pit. So this pit can start with the presence of chloride, that also causes pitting corrosion, that's caused the damage to the film and formation of a pit. And from pit there this crack initiates, and this may be transgranular stress corrosion cracking, TGSCC, or it may be intergranular stress corrosion cracking. Normally this transgranular is more common in the stress corrosion cracking, but intergranular when my material is already susceptible and is not proper solution annealed, then this also can occur. So here you can see the this initial pit forms due to the corrosive products. Then from the pit, this crack will initiate into the parent metal, and this is the due to the effect of the tensile forces that must be present. Okay, so this will further propagate the CLCC. Now we seen the pit. So this CLCC, there are different sites from where this CLCC may propagate. First we seen the pits formed due to the chloride. Second, if there is minor porosity present, this crack may propagate and CLCC may start. So these are the initiation sites for the CLCC. If there is a coarse machining marks, that also initiation site for this CLCC. If there is a fatigue crack is present in our material, this also initiation site for CLSAC. If there is a coating defect, that's also initiation site pit we already discussed. If there is a intergranular corrosion or slip band dissolution or dealloying, these are the initiation sites from where the CLSAC of the metal starts. So basically, first there will be a pit formation, or there is already some coarse mark or defect mark which act as an initiation site for this CLSAC, and from there the CLSAC will propagate in the metal and it may leak even 1 hour at high temperature and this environments. Okay, so first if all is dissolution of the protective film, metal dissolution, where there may be two reactions, anodic and cathodic, then there will be breakage of thick oxide film, means oxide film grade broken off, and then there will be a formation of this type of pit, and further this crack propagate due to plastic deformation, slip deformation or trim deformation. So here this is the basic mechanism of CLSCC. Hope you have understood. Now this is a very good image to visualize the CLSCC. So this you can see the cracks, branched cracks, and here in this image, if figure 5, there is the element distribution from the cracked area, means in crack area what are the elements. So basically see this black portion is showing the presence of the iron in that cracked portion. This red one is showing presence of the chromium. This showing presence of the oxygen in cracked portion. This is presence of the chloride, and this is presence of the nickel in the cracked portion. So from top left to bottom right, secondary electron image, the element distribution map of iron, chromium, oxygen, chlorine. The gap generated by the crack is filled with chromium rich oxide, and Cl element is also enriched at oxide region. Okay, and this image, this is also a CLSCC, and this is a image quality map. A is image quality map, B is the orientation map. Okay, so this is orientation of different grains, orientation map. C is the phase map obtained from the cracked area. This is a phase map, and D is the enlarged indication of the red rectangle slip traces denoted by the red line. Okay, so these are the austenites, green one, and these are the formation of martensite. So there will be high stress zones, and that will further cause the CLSCC. Now, how to calculate the risk of the CLSCC? So this reference is taken from the API 581. So we can identify what is risk for my current operating conditions if I am operating with chloride, oxygen, with pH and at different temperature range. Then we can divide our equipment piping on the based on their risk for the CLSCC. So basically this is the pH, and this is with chloride Cl 1 to 10. So no, 10 to 100. So this graph is for Ca chloride limit of 10 to 100. So see, up to 2.5 the CLSCC will not occur, pure HCl corrosion will occur. Here HCl corrosion will occur in this black range, but from above 2.5, if I am increasing the temperature, see here it will come to medium susceptibility up to from 25 degrees. So this area up to almost 35, there will be a minimum susceptibility. But if at this pH, 2.5 pH, if I am exceeding this 35 degree, I am coming in this zone, high susceptibility zone. Okay, And here you see, after this 9 or 9.2 pH, 9.5 pH, later there will be less chances of CLSCC. So based on this, we can classify these are the low risk zone, this is the medium risk zone, and this is the high risk zone, red one. And here there will not be chances of CLSCC. So either we are operating at very less temperature or very high pH, there will be no chance of the susceptibility of the CLSCC. So this table we can get from the API 581. Now this is also a tabulated form of that same image which we seen earlier slide. So here also there is a different temperature and different pH, you can see the probability, you can calculate the probability from this chart also. At different pH, at different temperatures, so this is a temperature, this is a pH, this is chloride from 10 to 100 ppm. So we can calculate where we are running at high, medium or low risk for CLSCC. So this chart is from 10 to 100 chloride. If my chloride is less than 10 ppm, then we have to reduce one susceptibility. Means if my risk is high and we are chloride is less than 10, then it will come to medium. Second is oxygen is also having critical role. So if my oxygen is less than 90 ppb, we have to decrease susceptibility by 1. Similarly, if my chloride is greater than 100 ppm, increase susceptibility 1. If we are medium, it will be high, and if we are high, it will be very high. And third is the deposits. If deposits are present in my process, then the susceptibility also increase by 1. So this is very important chart from API 581 latest addendum of 2020. Okay, so you can get from there. Now the last is how to prevent the CLSCC. So first of all, this CLSCC occurs in the 300 series of stainless steel that are more prone for CLSCC. In this range means nickel content from 10 to 18 19. So if we are increasing the nickel content, then the susceptibility of CLSCC will reduce, and higher nickel are basically resistant with the CLSCC. So if we cannot change in our process system, then we have to go for metallurgy upgradation, and we have to increase the nickel content to avoid this CLSCC. So this is first. Second, if we can control our process limits. So in process limits, what we can control, we have to limit the oxygen, because it can increase this electrode potential, which for CLSCC to occur in, it will shift the electrode potential in CLSCC range. Then we can limit the stresses. So stresses can be limited by the proper designing and proper fabrication procedures. Then if control of temperature, we can minimize our temperature, we can control this CLSCC. Either we have to control the pH, and if we increase our pH above 7 or 7 to 9 range, then we have less chances of the CLSCC to occur. So these are the few controls which we can do. For external CLSCC, external site for CLSCC to occur, we can use the paints, which can also prevent the CLSCC. Okay, so this is the chart. Here you can see this is the chloride weight percent. So this for ppm you can multiply by 10,000. Okay, so here see, for 316 304L, they are allowing up to 50 degree. Means if you are process conditions chloride versus temperature are below this range, you can use 304 or 316. But if you are exceeding the process condition above this, you have to go for the duplex. Okay, this is clean duplex, standard duplex, then super duplex. So if you are standard duplex, this is super duplex. So if your chloride is also increasing, temperature is also increasing, so you have to go for the metallurgy upgradation. You have to increase your nickel content. So this, from this table you can select your metallurgy appropriately. So these are the different metallurgies. Like here there will be 304, then 316, both are same susceptible, then 6MO with higher nickel, this is 20, this is 30, this is 40. Okay, so further Sanicro 28, A25. So if you increase your nickel content, it will be more resistant for the CLSCC. And the important thing is O2 limit. You have to control your oxygen limit. So dissolved oxygen in ppm. So here this is chloride concentration in ppm, this side, and here this side dissolved oxygen in ppm. So see here, up to 0.115 or 0.116, up to here there are less chance of CLSCC. So up to this 0.15 ppm and up to 10 ppm of chloride, this area is SCC safe area. But if your dissolved oxygen increase with 0.15, then you are in SCC sensitized area. Okay, so if this oxygen increase, your SCC will increase. So you have to be in this area. You have to control your oxygen up to this limit. That's also a critical factor which you have to take care. Okay, so hope you have understood this critical mechanism, and you have also understood this how to mitigate your CLSCC. So if you find this video useful, please share with your friends and subscribe my channel and see my other lecture series. And this is a lecture series on corrosion, this series to be continued. So stay tuned, subscribe me. Thank you.